Today's game is a 35-over Sunday friendly fixture against Chedworth Cricket Club. Chedworth is a beautiful ground located within the Cotswold and surrounded by beautiful Cotswold countryside and the nearby Roman villa. The ground itself has very short straight boundaries and very long square boundaries and is unique in that one boundary is a dry stone wall, reinforcing the Cotswold feel. The pitch had a varied covering of grass that was worn in some places but thicker in others. But having won the toss, we elected to make first use of the pitch and our openers got us off to a steady start. With one opener retired not out on 50, I came to the crease at the fall of the first wicket.
Unlucky, mate.
So he does have a wrong end.
Right. And that's what got you.
Yeah.
Waiting, no. Yep. Call it. Nope. Come, yep.
All right.
Yes.
Good.
It's a bit variable.
Yeah. Okay.
He's got a good bit of pace about him, that chap.
Yeah, exactly. And quite straight.
Yes.
Seems to be moving it a little bit, and then
yes.
The slope is helping.
Yes! Easy. No.
That might take a while to find.
I think it will do.
Here's your chance, just play it through.
Yeah.
Fast bowler. Okay. Tends to bring it in, that one he kept straight.
Okay.
And the bowler from the other side is leg break, but has a run.
Okay. Yeah, let's go. Just one. Yep. Yes. You're gonna need two. Yep. Oh, you got four. Nice one.
Should wait for that.
Came out in the middle though. Just.
Yeah, they cleared the inner ring, so you're fine.
So a frustrating end to an innings where I wanted to do very much better. Having been injured in a previous league game, I was hoping for some time in the middle, but at least I didn't go out swinging wildly across the line as I have done in previous innings. Our lower order batters weighed in with some runs to push our eventual score on to 179 for 7 from our 35 overs. Still a score we felt was light, especially with the short straight boundaries. Chedworth's openers got off to a flyer and we chased leather for the first 6 or 7 overs as they built a partnership. However, James Burton, our first change bowler, had an almost instant impact. Our joy was short-lived as the other Chedworth opener himself went on to score 50 and retire not out. At this stage, Chedworth were well ahead of the rate and well set for the win. At this point, our captain Matt Dex brought himself on to bowl. Normally a wicketkeeper, Matt's part-time medium pace initially got the same treatment. But cricket is a funny old sport and anything can happen. And usually does. Despite Matt's heroic part-time bowling, Chedworth edged their way closer to the win. This too brought their total to 178 for 5, just 2 runs short of the target and with 6 overs still remaining. With one of their batters having retired not out and another having to leave the game early, Chedworth needed 2 runs from 6 overs with 3 wickets remaining. At this point, Tim Collins, another wicketkeeper and part-time bowler, was in the attack. This wide brought the scores level. Chedworth needed just one more run for the win. But Matt Dex had not yet had the last word. That wicket brought Elliot Lockley to the crease. Chedworth still in search of one run, and Hathley now looking for just 2 wickets. Remarkably, Tim had taken 2 in 2, and Matt had his 4th catch of the match. Chedworth was still looking for one run for the victory. But now Hathley just needed one wicket. It had all come down to this. Sadly, it was not to be, as Chedworth won with 4 byes. A remarkable game that ended in a much tighter victory for Chedworth than should ever have been. If you've watched thus far and enjoyed the video, please consider subscribing to the channel. And if you want a notification every time I upload a new match video, be sure to also click on the bell icon. Until next time, from myself, Mike, the old bloke playing cricket, you take care.